Yaskawa.
You're watching the PLCopen Basics video tutorial series. This video shows how to initialize the access variables used by all PLCopen function blocks. Hi, I'm Matt Pelletier. In order to program a particular servo axis to enable or to move, the question is, which axis are you referring to? PLCopen standardizes this axis definition using a structure called axis ref. In MotionWorks IEC, basically all you have to do is type the logical axis number from hardware configuration into the initial value of the axis num element of this structure. But I'd like to give you a more thorough explanation and demonstration, so please follow along with me in the class project. If you look at any of the PLCopen function blocks, they all have one thing in common, and that is that this top connection is for this axis variable. And the variable that it's looking for is a data structure with the axis ref data type. Axis ref is a structure that is individually defined by each manufacturer who implements PLCopen. And it could contain a large amount of data. And so to save memory in the controller, PLCopen defines that axis ref is not an input variable, but instead a var in out. And this means that the data is not copied into the function block instance in memory, but instead it's referenced directly from the original memory location. This means that for any block with the axis var in out, there is no initial value, and the axis var in out must be connected for the block to compile. The axis ref data type definition is not defined by PLCopen because of the hardware-specific data that it can contain. So instead, each vendor defines their own axis ref structure. This way, through one axis ref variable, all axis-specific information, such as, for example, the axis number, maximum speed, encoder resolution, or user units, or any other data that the manufacturer wants, can be referenced by the PLCopen function blocks through this variable. So each block just takes whatever data it needs from the axis ref to operate that axis correctly. So what about Yaskawa's implementation of axis ref? Well, we can see this data type defined in the data types toolbox. Let me do this live here. So this data types toolbox can be seen in the library tab. We'll just go here to data types toolbox, data types, and it's called motion block types because it has to do with motion. Just like we need to go up a little bit to axis ref. And you see that we have one element called axis num and no other elements. You see, the MPIEC controllers have all of the axis data, like encoder resolution and user units, in the hardware configuration. So there's really no need to redefine all those details here in the variable structure. So that's why we see Yaskawa's implementation containing just one single element called axis num. And what this means is the logical axis number. This one number points to all the other axis-specific information that's already residing in the controller. But this doesn't mean that Yaskawa can't change that in the future. So while we have just one element now, as hardware functionality progresses, there is the option in the future to be able to add elements to our custom axis ref data type as implemented by Yaskawa. So what are the axis numbers for the axes in our demo project? To see those numbers, we have to go to the hardware configuration. And so let's demonstrate that if you'd like to follow along with me. I know we said that this training is about PLCopen and not hardware configuration, but there are times like this when they are closely connected. So we'll click on one of the axes, like screw, and in the configuration tab, we see parameter 1831, logical axis number. So our screw is logical axis number 1. Rotary is logical axis 2. If you have the MP2600 IEC, you'll see that the project has set the rotary as a virtual axis with logical axis 27. Our project also has a virtual axis, and you can see that the logical axis number here is 26. And although you can't control the motion, you do have the external axis, the external encoder, which is also an axis, logical axis number 21. So we do have four axes on this system, two real, one virtual, and one external encoder. And again, the MP2600 IEC has just one real, which we're using this screw to represent the real axis, and the rotary is another virtual axis, just so we can do the same programming exercises. What's of further interest in MotionWorks IEC version 3 is that right above the axis number is also the axis name. This name is important because this name has created an axis ref variable already for us. If you have version 2, you'll have to create this on your own. So back to the programming interface. I'll go to the project tab and come down here to global variables. And you see that these already exist. These exist because the hardware configuration creates an axis ref with that same name. So we got a rotary axis ref, a screw axis ref, a virtual, and the external. Four axis ref variables. While these variables are automatically created, you'll notice that they are not automatically initialized. The initial value is not given. And that's because these are structures which could have multiple elements. So in MotionWorks IEC version 3, we have a new option here under the view menu called Initialize Multi-Element Variable Window. So you can pull that up, and then you'll see a window where you can type in the initial value for each of these. So I'll go through and do that along with you for one of them, this screw. Here I'll go to View, Initialize Multi-Element Variable Window. You may have to adjust that window size and position. I'm going to adjust these columns, shrink that description, and then right here under the axis num element, we know that we want this screw to be axis number 1, because that's what we saw in the hardware configuration, was that this screw was logical axis 1. When you click off of it, you can see the little code that it puts in here. And just to make this training friendly for any of you who might be using this with MotionWorks IEC 2, these features of the axis names, the automatic axis variable creation, and the multi-element variable initialization don't exist for MotionWorks IEC 2. So instead, you can manually create those axis variables using the F5 key and just create the variable and use the data type axis ref. And then to initialize them, we don't have the multi-element variable window in MotionWorks IEC 2. Instead, you can use this type of text line in a structured text program. And if you'd like to see a demonstration of how to do it this way with MotionWorks IEC 2 and text code, please refer to the Quick Start video. And now for your first programming challenge, if you can call it that, whether it will be truly a program or truly a challenge, will be yet to be determined. But I want to see if you can, on your own, go and successfully initialize each of the axes on this system. Remember, we have the two real axes, screw and rotary, and then also the virtual axis and the external encoder. And then to prove that it works, put each variable, like I've shown here, into the watch window, and then you'll be able to see the current value that they have. You can also verify the operation of these initial values with warm start and cold start. Okay, so please pause the video, give it a shot, and when you're done, or if you need a hint, play the video and I'll show you how I did it. So I will continue to initialize. Here's the rotary. And I do remember that was axis number 2, logical axis 2. Hit enter. Now click on the virtual. And just in case you don't remember the virtual's logical number, we click on it and see that it is number 26. And you can refresh your memory on external. That was number 21. So back to the multi-element initialization. We'll give 26. Hit enter. Click on external. That was number 21. And enter. So now I need to make those changes. Now we'll try it out in the controller. Looks like I'm not connected. Log into my link manager. All right, looks like I'm in. And we'll do download. And then we'll do a cold start. Could do warm start or cold start. And now we wanted to see these in the debug mode, in the watch window. So we go to debug mode. And then we can add these one by one to the watch window. First, I will view the watch window. Yeah, I may have to move those around here. Okay. So now the screw. Add to watch. And you click OK to have the whole element. All right, that one looks good. Then rotary. Add to watch. That one looks good. Virtual. Add to watch. Looks good. External, add to watch. And looks good. Again, if you're doing the MP2600 IEC, then the rotary you should have set to 27. And of course, you could overwrite these. This wouldn't usually happen. You can overwrite these, and you'll notice then if you do a stop and a warm start, they'll go back. Stop and a cold start, same thing. These variables are not retained, so that's why whether it is warm start or cold start, the initial value is applied. And I think I would leave it that way. We really don't want these to change. Otherwise, you'd start controlling a different axis if it existed. Very well, we have each of the axes now initialized to the correct logical axis number, and we can proceed with our program.